70. This is kind of fun. GC mass spec, gas chromatography / mass spectroscopy. In my opinion, the mass spec is the king of the pile in a laboratory. The mass spec is like incredibly powerful. There's things you can do with the mass spec that you can't do with anything else. The people that make them are getting better and better and better at it. The instruments are getting more robust, easier to operate, cheaper. The mass spec is like you just fall in love with those things. They're not particularly difficult to operate. GC mass spec is a partnership between gas chromatography and mass spectroscopy. Of that partnership, the dominant player really is the GC. The gas chromatography forms the separation. If the separation is done properly, then the mass spec really doesn't have to do much. And if the separation is not done properly, there isn't anything the mass spec can do about it. If the mass spec is running well, it can't fix problems that are caused by poor chromatography. The EPA 8270 is a very sophisticated analysis, largely because of the quality control. The quality control constraints in the 8270 are mostly the mass spec, a very powerful detector, being used to evaluate the performance of the GC. So the quality control is all about the GC. It's not really about the mass spec so much. Gas chromatography. The operative word is gas. The GC separates compounds based upon their behavior as a gas, but the semi-volatile 8270, the sample is injected as a liquid. The typical injection is a microliter in methylene chloride. That microliter is injected into a space about the size of a thimble. It's pretty small. It's about 260 degrees centigrade. 260 degrees centigrade is hot enough to explode the methylene chloride into vapor, but it's also hot enough that anything you want to analyze for will be a gas. It's under pressure. So it's injected into this space under pressure. Everything goes to vapor, and the vapor is pushed into the column. Once it's in the column, it's all pretty straightforward. The Achilles heel of the GC is in the injection phase, getting the sample cleanly from the liquid into the gas phase and then into the column is really the key to it. A typical routine for a mass spec operator is you come to work. The first thing you do is you turn off the GC oven and you turn off the GC injector to let them cool down. Go about your business. You know, it's a lot of administration. Go about your administrative business, maybe get your standards ready or whatever for the day. Let the injector cool down. Put on a pair of gloves, cotton, and let's take a look at this. The injection system takes a lot of different forms with different gas chromatographs, but I think this is a pretty good general representation. The port liner is nothing more than a glass tube. It's about the diameter of a pencil, about 2.5 inches long. It is held freely from the top and the bottom in a sleeve. The sleeve accepts a nut, both on the top and on the bottom. Let's look at the top first. The top has an O-ring. The O-ring is squeezed down by a nut, and so the O-ring forms the seal between the sleeve and the port liner. And then this nut also has a little place that accepts the septum, and then another nut that goes on top and holds the septum in place. So the needle goes through the top nut, through the septum, through the bottom nut. The whole system is pressurized from the top and sealed with the O-ring. To take it apart, it's fairly simple. The top nut, which is green, is unscrewed, revealing the septum. The septum is then pried out, and this loosens up the lower nut, which is black in this drawing, and then that unscrews. When that nut is taken off, the port liner is just sitting there, and the O-ring is just sitting there. You just pull them both out, put the new port liner in, slide the O-ring over it, slide the black nut over that, snug it down, put the new septum in, put the green nut back on, and snug it down. And that's pretty much all there is to it. The bottom, now this is inside of the oven, also has a nut. The nut is part of the seal, and the seal is actually through a little gold plate and then a little gasket, but it's snugged up against the bottom. The port liner just sits on this plate, but so that the nut holds the seal, makes a seal, and then into this nut is yet another receiver which takes the column. Let's turn our attention to the column itself. The column is very, very, very small. It's 30 meters long, so that's about longer than a football field. It's very long and very thin. The column goes in to the injector with a nut and a ferrule. As an example, and this is like applied industrial engineering. I want to take a quick look at this. Looks like it came out of a bathroom, and in fact it did. Notice our working parts. We have a washer. I think of it as a ferrule. I don't think plumbers call it that, but whatever. And there's a nut, and then this would be the column. So put the nut on, put the washer, and notice this washer is tapered such that it fits it right in here exactly. So put the nut on, put the ferrule on, put the whole thing in here, and then this guy comes up, and as this guy turns around and is tightened up, it pushes this washer into the groove around it and makes the seal. The technology, the engineering for the GC column is identical. Let's take a look at the column itself. The column is, it's so small, it's hard to believe that it's actually hollow. This is the standard 8270 column. This, I believe, is a megabore. I found these in a file, so I'm not exactly sure, but I think this is the megabore from the 8240, which is the volatile GC mass spec. But it's small. It's small to the point that it's just incredibly small. And it's 30 meters long. So, I don't know. But anyway, that's the way it is. So the routine is this. As part of regular maintenance, this is in the oven now, okay? Open the oven door. It should be cooled off reasonably well. Loosen the nut with a little wrench. It's a little tiny nut with a little tiny wrench. Loosen it, pull the column out. It'll just come right out. Make a note of how much column sticks out of the ferrule while you're at it. Cut off about 18 inches of column. Just cut it off and throw it away. Slide the nut over the remaining part. Slide the ferrule over the remaining part. Take the column cutter and cut off a little bit more of the end. The argument is that the graphite ferrule is a reactive substance, and the graphite pieces will stick to the cut glass and cause problems. So you want to cut off the end so you got a fresh cut. The way to do this is to gently scratch the column with the column cutter and then gently break it off. The column cutter is like a little piece of quartz. It's a material that's harder than glass. I've seen them made out of carbide steel. It's usually just a little quartz crystal. You look around your lab and you can find one. And then put the same amount of column coming out of the ferrule that you saw, stick it back up where it belongs, take the nut, twist it back on, snug it down with a little wrench. Gas chromatography is all about time and temperature. The temperature of the oven goes up and down as part of its programming. The temperature of the injector should stay the same. You need to keep these temperature zones separate. And the way to do it is to be sure to put the little cover back on. There's a little cover that goes up around the injector. Make sure that cover's put back on. When I was a new lab tech faced with a situation like this, I was completely terrified. Chemistry is abstract anyway. The instruments are completely magical, and it was just really scary. It's not that difficult. It's certainly no more complicated than other mechanical aspects in our lives. Study the manual. Ask the people around you if they have anything to say, and just do it.